Hey, what's going on everybody? It's your bro here. Hope you're doing well. And in this video, I'm going to teach you guys how we can create a clock program in Python. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. If you find this video helpful, please remember to like, comment, and subscribe. Your support will help keep this channel running. All right, my fellow bros, in this video, we're going to be creating a clock GUI program. So we'll need a few imports from tkinter, import everything. And from time, import everything as well. We'll need a window, window equals tk, followed by window.mainloop. And in this program, we're going to be creating three separate labels, one for the time, another for the day of the week, and another for the date. So let's begin with just displaying the time, and we'll work on the day of the week and the date later. So let's create a label for the time called time label equals label. We're adding this to the window. And let's set the font because we can. I'm going to choose maybe Arial and then a size of 50 so that this is somewhat large. I'm going to change the foreground color, that is the font color, and I will pick a hex value of green. So that is 00FF00, but feel free to pick whatever color you want. And I'm also going to set the background color, and you can pick a hex value or a color name. I'm just going to say black. And then I am going to pack this label, time label dot pack. Now we're going to call a function and we'll call this update. And we'll define what this does. After every second has passed, we will use a recursive function to keep on updating the time every 1 second or so. So let's define what this function does. Def update. There is a function within the time module called strftime, which we can use to return the current time and format it however we want. So we're going to actually place this within a string variable and we'll call this time string. And this function is strftime. I'm actually going to go to Python's website just to give you an example of how this works. Here we are on Python's website, and this is the strftime function. And this converts a tuple representing a time as returned by GM time or local time to a string as specified by the format arguments. So when we call this function, we can pass in directives as arguments based on what we want to display. If we want to display the current time, there is a few directives that we can pass in. So let's say that we want a 12-hour clock as represented by a decimal number between 1 and 12. Well, we would pass in %i as an argument. If we want the minutes, that would be right here, %m. And if we want the seconds, that is %s. So we're going to pass in these directives as if they are arguments. So within this function, we'll pass in those format specifiers or directives. So I want %i followed by %m and %s. All right. But these also have to be within quotes, so don't forget that because I just did. Okay, this will display the current time. Oh, then we also have to update our time label. So time label dot config text equals our time string, because remember that this returns a string of text. Text equals time string. So this will display the current time. And right now it is 6 in the morning or so. However, we just get one long jumbled number. So it would be a good idea if we separated some of these numbers. So within our strf time function, I'm just going to add some colons to separate these values. And this will display the current time. It is currently 6:46 in the morning. Let's add AM or PM to the end of this. So the directive for that is percent lowercase p. 6:46 AM. Now, how do we update this label every 1 second to reflect the current time? Well, that's a good question and I'm glad you asked it. So we're going to use the time labels after function. We pass in a delay and then a function that we want to call after that delay. So let's say we want to call this function update every 1000 milliseconds or 1 second. So we'll pass in the delay as an argument, 1000 milliseconds, and the function that we want to call. And we're going to perform what is known as a recursive function. We're going to call a function within itself. So after 1000 seconds, we're going to call update again, and it's going to repeat the process. It's going to return the time and format that time and update our label with the new time. So what ends up happening now is that our clock is going to update every 1000 milliseconds. Now let's add a few other labels. Let's say the day of the week. I'm going to copy what we have here, and let's rename this as day label. But I probably don't want this to be the same size. For the font, let's say ink free, because I like that font. And a size of maybe 25, and I'll get rid of the coloring. It's the same process as before, really. So let's replace time string with day string. The directive for strf time to display the day of the week is percent a. And we're going to replace time label with day label, text equals day string. And this will display the day of the week, and it is currently Wednesday. And if we want to display the current date, we can create a label, and we'll call this date label. And I'll make the font slightly bigger, maybe 30. We'll copy what we have for our day string and rename this as date string. So we have a few options for the date. I want to display the name of the month, the day, and then the year. So that would be percent, capital B, percent, lowercase d. I'm going to add a comma to separate the day and the year, and percent capital Y. And then I want to set the text of my date label to my date string so that this will now display the current date. There's just one quick change that I think we should make. Right now we have three different labels, a time label, a day label, and a date label. And right now we're using the after function of the time label. So since we have all of these different labels, I think we should replace time label with our window, because our window has an after function as well, so that after 1000 milliseconds has passed, we can update the time, the day of the week, and the date. All right, so that's the basics of creating a simple clock program in Python. If you want a copy of all this code, I'll post all of this in the comments down below. But yeah, that's the basics of creating a clock in Python.
Hey you. Yeah, I'm talking to you. If you learn something new, then you can help me help you in three easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.